In this tutorial, we'll go over how to locate and use the theme options panel that comes with Divi. Once you enable the Divi theme, a new tab will be added to your WordPress dashboard. On the sidebar, under the Appearances section, look for the Divi theme options link. Clicking that will bring you to ePanel, which has several options that control several parts of your page. There'll be more details about this below the video. And we also have a lot of documentation about general ePanel settings within our docs section in the members area. So when you log in to the Elegant Themes members area, click the docs link and it'll bring you to our documentation, which gives you a lot of basic information about theme installation and ePanel configuration. But coming back to ePanel, I can just go over a few things. Under the General Settings tab, it has a lot of general settings like your logo, uploading your logo, defining a favicon. You can enable grab the first post image, so if you enable this, then the first post image in any of your posts will be used as your featured image if it's not defined. You can input your MailChimp API key for the sign-up module. Here you control the social media icons in the footer. You can enable or disable the Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, and RSS icons. And below that, you can control the URL of each icon. You can adjust how many posts are displayed by default in various sections of your website, like categories and archives, search results, tags. You can adjust the basic date format that appears in those sections as well. There's also a custom CSS section where you can add custom CSS. So if you have some basic changes you want to make, but you don't want to make a child theme, you can add them to the custom CSS panel. Under the navigation tab, here you can, if you are not using the Appearances Menus tab, then you can use this to kind of exclude and include links in your navigation bar. So you can just remove links that you don't want to include in the navigation bar. Or you can just use the Appearances Menus section to create a custom menu instead. So here you can choose which categories and which pages appear. You can choose whether to enable drop-down menus or not, limit the number of tiers in drop-down menus, change the link order, etc. Layout settings. On your posts and pages, you have a few options. You can, on posts, you can enable or disable different pieces of the metadata that appears, like your author link and date and the categories of the post and the number of comments. You can toggle comments on and off on all of your posts. You can decide whether or not to display thumbnails in your posts or not. The same goes for pages. You can turn thumbnails on and off or show comments or not. Ad management. There's several areas in the theme where you can input advertisements. So you can fill out your banner URL and image here. We have several SEO settings. You can customize your SEO titles and keywords and descriptions, enable canonical URLs, and a few other things here. The integration tab lets you easily integrate custom scripts into various parts of your website, like into the head or body, into the top of posts, into the bottom of posts. Yeah, and so that's a basic overview of ePanel. For more information, look below this video or check out our documentation inside the members area.